There's going to come a time in Adobe Animate CC where you might want to show or hide different objects. Now there are a lot of ways to do this, some of them are more complicated than others. In this tutorial video, we'll show you a basic way to show or hide objects, and this may or may not work for what you're trying to use, but it might at least get you started. So before we start the tutorial, let's see what this looks like. Right now you can see that there's an empty space, and what we are going to show here is an Australian sticker. If we click on Show Sticker, it shows it, and if we click on Hide, it hides it. Pretty basic, but let's see the script behind it. In this finished script, we can see that the Australia sticker has the visibility of false, which means it is going to start by not showing. Then we create a function that allows the Show button to reveal the Australia sticker by creating visibility of true, yes it is visible, when clicked. Then when we click the Hide button, it's going to change the visibility of the Australia sticker to false, so it's going to hide it again. Let's see how we did this. Now when looking at this project, we've already created the buttons. If you don't know how to create buttons, make sure that you look at my animation tutorials. And we have the buttons on one layer and the sticker on another. Now for each of these buttons, they're already converted to button symbols, but this object right here is not a symbol yet. In order to use ActionScript in your project, you must have objects that have been converted to symbols. So in order to do this, I'll click on this Australian sticker, go up to Modify, and choose Convert to Symbol. I'm going to call it Movie Clip, so MC, and AUS for Australia, and Sticker. Notice that I always put MC to identify the type of symbol, and I put it at the front of the word in order to identify this as a symbol name instead of something called an instance name, which we'll talk about in a minute. Then I give it identifying words and not something generic like just sticker, because what if later on in this game or lesson or activity, I have multiple different types of stickers? This helps me to identify this as the Australian sticker. So I'll click OK, and now I can target that with ActionScript. We'll go up to the Window menu, make sure the Actions panel is open. As you can see, I dock mine on the left here, and also open up the panel called Code Snippets. When you get to the Code Snippets, we're going to open up the ActionScript folder, go to the Actions folder, and the two actions that we're going to focus on is Click to Hide an Object and Show an Object. Now this is a little bit confusing because we're actually going to use the Show an Object action to hide the sticker. So even though it says only Show an Object, it's going to allow you to either choose to show it or hide it. So with this symbol selected, we'll double click to show an object, and it's going to give me a warning that says that this symbol does not have an instance name. It is required to have an instance name in ActionScript. Now, if you just say OK to this, it's going to give this symbol a generic instance name, which might be fine, but it becomes confusing in your code because it gives it a bunch of generic instance names and you don't know what it's referring to. So I'm actually going to hit cancel, and everything I want to target with ActionScript, I need to add an instance name to. So I'll click on the Australia sticker, go to the Properties panel, and look up here at the top of the Properties panel and add an instance name. Now this should be different than what its original symbol name is. If we look in the library, you can see that the symbol name was MC Aus Sticker. The symbol name for the Show button and the Hide button are BTN Hide and BTN Show. So again, I put the indicator of the symbols at the beginning of the words when I'm naming a symbol. But when I'm naming an instance, I actually put it at the end. That way I can visually distinguish the difference between a symbol name and an instance name. So for this object, I'll click on instance name, and I'll give it the exact same identifying name of Aus Sticker. Notice that the capitalization is the same as the symbol name. That's not required, but it is something I like to do to keep it consistent. Just know that when you do add this into ActionScript, the spelling, capitalization, everything has to be exactly perfect. So after Aus Sticker, I'm going to put underscore MC because this is a movie clip symbol. So again, I like to indicate what type of symbol it is, but because this is an instance name and I may need to make it different than the symbol name, I put it after the identifying text. So now this is the instance name. For the show sticker, I'm going to do the same thing, show underscore BTN to indicate that this is a BTN symbol, and then hide underscore BTN. So those instance names are going to show up in our ActionScript when we add code snippets. So again, clicking on my sticker, or the object I want to hide, the first thing I need to do is I need to start it off by hiding it. Otherwise, there's no point in clicking the show button and testing that out. Or we can click the show button, but it won't even look like it's working because the symbol will already be showing. So let's double click the show an object code snippet. And you can see in this comment area that it gives you a comment explaining what you need to do. So it's saying right now, the Australia sticker MC visibility is true. So true, it is visible. But if we don't want it to be visible, we need to change this to false. So true and false is kind of like yes or no, black and white, salt and pepper. You have either or option. So if you don't want it to be showing, then the visibility should be false. If you do want it to be showing, then it should be true. So you can comment this out. You can delete this comment, or you could add something like, this makes the sticker hide when we first start the movie. Okay, so that's just a note for me to help me to remember what is happening in this instance. You, again, don't have to have that. You can write whatever note you want to make. Just remember to keep this ending and starting symbol. That way it knows it's a comment and it's not actually script that it should run. Okay, so let's test this out. Let's go to Control and click Test. It's going to load it, and this project is really big because I have the most complicated texture back here. But looking at this Swift, now we can see that that sticker is not actually showing. When we first start this movie, it doesn't show. Now when I click these buttons, nothing happens, and that's because we haven't added the script to make those buttons function. So let's go down here in our action script and start adding that functionality. So we'll click on the show sticker, go to code snippets, and then we're going to actually do click to hide an object. So even though it's the show button and we want people to click to show an object, it says it's click to hide an object, so it's a little tricky in that regard. But we'll double click that. And again, we have a comment in here that you can choose to comment out, and I'm just going to delete that for now. And what it's going to basically say is the show button, notice there's the instance name. We can see the instance names here and here. And so it's not a generic instance name, which makes it easier to understand what it's doing. So now the show button is listening for an event, which is basically listening for a click. And when it hears a click or feels a click, whatever it may be, it's going to hide this object. Well, even though it says click to hide as the function name, we actually want to make it true, so the visibility is true, so it is showing. Now right here it's saying it's going to show when the show button is clicked, it's going to show the show button, which doesn't make any sense. So we need to change this to the Australian sticker instance name. So we'll do aus sticker underscore MC. So we're saying when the show button is clicked, it's going to perform this function to make the Australia sticker visible. So let's go ahead and test that out. And as this loads, it should start out with the sticker not showing. And then when we click the show sticker, it should show it. And it works. Now the only thing left to do is make the hide sticker actually hide it after the fact. So again, let's click on the hide sticker, go to code snippets, and double click to hide an object. I'm going to delete this comment. Again, you can use that if you want to. And it's saying the hide button, when it hears a click, it's going to perform this function. Now, you could have copied and pasted this. The only problem is you can't have the same function name. So once you copy and paste this, this function name would be the same here and here, and it would cause an error. So you can copy and paste this, just know that you have to put an underscore two, like you see here, in order to make it actually function. So let's see what this is saying. The hide button, when it's clicked, will perform the function to actually hide the hide button, so that doesn't make any sense. We're going to make it so that it hides the sticker, aus sticker underscore MC. So this is basically saying the Australia sticker should be hiding when we first get into the movie. Then when we click the show button, it's going to show the Australia sticker, and when we click the hide button, it's going to hide the Australia sticker. So let's go ahead and preview that. And I just did command return or control enter to preview the movie quickly. Again, it's hiding when we first start. Now I can click to show it, click to hide it, click to show it, click to hide it, on and on and on. So that's the basic way to show and hide objects in Animate CC. If you want to see the full code that I've actually added some comments to, you can look here and pause this video.